I'll ever find, the more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
Welcome back to the Cantina. This is Stephanie, your friendly neighborhood quarantined cantina owner, operator, Wookiee Wrangler, chaos coordinator, scoundrel, coordinator, you know, that person. We'll talk a little bit about this. Now, I do have compromised lungs. Y'all know the story. Back in 1987, I caught... I was anorexic. I weighed about 90 pounds. I caught the flu. There's a very bad flu going around, which left my immune system, you know, basically very compromised. And I almost died of pneumonia. I spent 3.5 months in the hospital at Mayo Clinic, St. Mary's in Rochester, Minnesota, which is Mayo Clinic. First in a semi drug-induced coma, then out of it, but you know, that's called a tracheotomy scar. And then 1 month there in inpatient rehab to gain weight, gain strength back, be able to walk under my on my own. Because when you're stuck in a bed for, let's say, a month or more, and you don't have any body weight to you anyway, what's left of your muscles atrophies into oblivion. So you lose a lot of strength. You'd be shocked. Every step you take when you're first relearning to walk, relearning to use your hands, relearning to eat, relearning to do the fine motor skills. You have physical therapy. I of course had respiratory therapy, and I hated those people because I'd screw around with the ventilator and do all kinds of things that either scared me or hurt. Occupational therapy, hands. So, you know, you go through a lot, if you've been as sick as I was. So I kind of understand the need for, quarantining, self isolation and stuff like that for people with compromised immune systems, compromised anything. I've got compromised lungs. I'm here by myself. I haven't really gone anywhere in the last... I went to the store the other day, about 2 or 3 days ago. My clinic, the one I go to for, you know, my physicals, blood, you know, the usual thing, they had someone test hot for corona. Now, to be honest, now I'm going to say this. To be honest, the people who've gotten it in my neck of the woods have traveled back and forth between Montgomery County, Delaware County, Philadelphia County, Bucks County, in the Philadelphia area, all right? So, you know, there's that. So, are we doing person-to-person infections here yet? I don't know. I'll find out more when my husband gets home, because his job is partly emergency management. So, I get the real deal, the real scoop. And I hold out hope. He thinks the sky's falling. Anyway, so what do you do on a day like this? Well, you can watch CNN, but, you know, and this actually is going to be about CNN. When the president proposed to ban travel from China, Korea, Japan, other places, have Americans that had been overseas there quarantined till they could pass the test that they weren't giving off. You know, they weren't passing the virus on anybody. MSNBC called him racist. And, you know, we'll just say that CNN did too. Now, the past couple of days since he declared emergency on Friday, Saturday? Whenever? Last Friday. They're trying to frame it like he's been caught flat-footed, but he wasn't. You know, there's a lot of stuff going on. stuff I kind of don't agree with. I don't agree with shutting everything down. You know, I don't agree with shutting down the entire economy. You know, but if they feel, if they're the experts, if they feel like they have to do it, go with God. Okay, as long as you keep me safe, I don't care. But it's really interesting how you've got private companies like Walmart and others getting on board to make it easier for Americans to get medicine, to get supplies. The supply chain is fine. You know, it's just, we've got idiots panic buying. Stop it, okay? And also, let this be a lesson to you people who are prepared. Go to wisefoods.com, Mountain House, etc., and buy a month's supply of freeze-dried, dehydrated food, okay? Go back to the grocery store when it's full, get a great big huge bag full of rice and several bags full of dried beans, keep them somewhere where they're kept clean in an airtight, in a container. Because guess what? This is gonna happen again, okay? We live in a global society now, which sucks. Maybe it won't be so global after this, I don't know. However, you know, we weren't caught flat-footed because my husband won't allow that to happen. We've got everything we need. I feel bad for people who don't. If you live next door to the elderly, do not show up to their house, call them, see how they're doing. If you do have to go to their house, wear a mask. These are the most vulnerable of all of us. And, you know, make sure they have everything they need. They got water, they got food, they got medicine. If they need something at the store, I'm saying this right now, even if you're healthy and you've got nothing going on, wear a goddamn mask. Okay? Just do it. Carry, if you have wipes, carry them with you. Carry something that you can wipe your hands off with when you go to the grocery store to touch the cart. This thing apparently lives 5-6 hours on surfaces. All right? I have been told and been told this is bullshit, that this thing dies off as many, you know, like cold viruses and flu viruses at the temperature of 68 degrees. You know, I've been told by people who think they know everything that that's wrong. You know, I'm giving it 2 weeks. 2 weeks, you should see warmer weather here. It's 70 degrees here today. A lot of people in the South have probably traveled that have it. You know, again, if it dies in warmer weather and you're using air conditioning, I'm not saying don't use air conditioning. That's not what I'm saying. But I'm trying to figure out how it got where the transmission is coming from. Okay. You've got cruises going out there. You might as well have a floating Petri dish. Norovirus, anybody? Ain't no way I'm ever doing that. Anyway, so, you know, we've got CNN and NBC and you know, these trash media outlets attacking the president. Today he took them on and he ripped them to smithereens. You know, these people are basically regurgitating Chinese communist propaganda. Now, instead of saying, well, how did this start? We know how it started. There are three different scenarios. I've got a friend who doesn't think it started with the bat. He's convinced it was a bioweapon that got loose. It's still a virus carried by bats. Bats are significantly more disease-ridden than any animal in the world. This is go look it up. Newsweek posted an article about it. I posted it on my Facebook page. It is freaky. Bats are disgusting. Okay. They might do wonderful things. Don't eat them. Don't go near them. They have a purpose to be over there eating bugs. Okay. Not, you know, the main ingredient for hellspawn and broth. Okay. Just telling you that right now. Anyway, back in the 70s, the Chinese were in the middle, of course, of famine because they're a managed economy. And this is what happens when the government is involved with everything from food production to manufacturing to, you know, how many kids you can have. I mean, they're just, it's it's ridiculous. But anyway, they had a famine, and people were literally eating whatever that they could find. You know, rats, lizards, you know, just filthy animals, bats, monkeys, whatever they could get their little hands on. And the Chinese government realized it was a source of income, it was a source of nutrition, and let them start wildlife farming. So you've got bats being raised by so-called farmers in China to sell at these wet markets. Look up wet markets. When you see the videos from them and you see animals in cages piled up, shit dropping on from the top to the bottom, you think foodborne illnesses are going to come through? Yeah, okay. There's a reason why bird flu, people can get that, you know, swine flu. And it's all because you might have a managed food supply, you're not keeping it clean, okay? Yell at us all you want about being capitalist pigs. I'm going to stop this video in a second because I want to talk about something that happened a long time ago in history. I'll bring up a book that changed everything in the United States about how animals are kept, how they're slaughtered, how they're butchered, how they're presented to the public for buying and consuming. Okay. But anyway, these wet markets. So this animal was either a farmed bat or maybe it was a caught bat. Bought, turned into bat stew. The guy who ate it caught this bug from this creature and spread it all over like, you know, typhoid fucking Mary. And apparently, I've heard he actually survived. Okay. Or, and this is the thing that really kind of intrigues me. The bat in question was being either tested for a virus that they could turn into a bioweapon or there's two labs in Wuhan, China. Okay. They are both under the leadership of a Chinese general who runs their bioweapons program. Okay. Let's go further. Anyway. This animal was being tested for the virus. The virus was taken out of the animal. And when they didn't need it anymore, because they had what they wanted from it, it was sold on the black market to somebody at the wet market who sold it to typhoid Mr. Jiang, who then spread it all over Higgledy-Piggledy all over Wuhan. All right. Or it got loose from the bioweapons lab. It was definitely something they did not want out. It got out and started spreading all over the place. All right. I'm not saying it's not a bat-borne illness. I'm saying somehow, some way, the Chinese military is probably part of this. Now, you'll have idiots repeating the Chinese propaganda machine. It was U.S. military. They just, you know, this is how dumb people think you are, okay? That you'd actually believe something that stupid. And remember, Chinese propaganda, you know? It's kind of like believing anything that came out of Nazi Germany or Stalinist Russia. All right. So that's probably how it started. And the reason why I think it might be three, or might be a combination of two and three in this, is because the Chinese government did everything they could to cover it up until it got so bad they couldn't anymore. Okay? They knew it was bad in December. This thing started in November, by the way. They knew it was bad in December. And we've seen what they've been doing to their own people as a result of this. So, and, you know, when you've got CNN, MSNBC, CBS, ABC, you know, and other left-wing news institutions repeating the Communist Party Chinese line, whose side are they on? All right? And I want you to think about that when you turn on a news conference and say, you know, the president bitch slapped them. This thing wasn't born in the United States. That's their propaganda. That's a lie. It was born in Wuhan, China. Somehow, again, and what's really strange and is it a coincidence that both of their big laboratories that belong under the auspices of their chem bioweapons program are in that place too? Quinkinink? I think not. But let's go to the little
Okay, video. So we're back. I want to talk a little bit about the book, The Jungle, written by novelist, journalist, polemist, socialist, Upton Sinclair. It's called, like I said, The Jungle. It was written in 1906. He basically wanted to write something that talked about the lives of immigrants to forward socialism. It kind of did not do what he wanted it to do because there are passages in it about the conditions of meatpacking plants that were so horrifying that Americans were like, and President Roosevelt, Teddy Roosevelt at the time, was so disgusted, I mean, just outraged by what he read, that the FDA was born, the Federal Food and Drug Administration, in order to keep the food supply, the food chain, the food supply clean in the United States. And when you think about a capitalistic country having, you know, it's, you know, regulations on things like the meat industry to keep it clean, the food industry itself to keep it healthy, clean, so consumers won't get sick from it is a very, very important thing. And of course, it also oversees drug companies, medicines, things like that. And it's also another important thing. So people won't get sick from medicine they're taking. Okay. This is why we have, when you're watching a TV show and all of a sudden they come on with, you know, some ad for some brand new medicine and all of a sudden you get 20 minutes of, you know, if this happens, call the doctor. Because the Food and Drug Administration has put it through testing so they know what the side effects are going to be and put it out there so the consumer can find out what it's like. Sinclair, of course, did not want to write that. He wanted to expose the harsh conditions of immigrants in the United States. His ideas on politics are a whole video in of itself. But anyway, I find it ironic that the United States could have something like the Food and Drug Administration to protect the food supply, the pharmaceutical supply, and communist China, you know, state run this, state run that, can't even keep a lid on their own food supply. Sure, you want to eat bats. We don't care if they're disease-ridden, filthy animals. Go ahead. You know? I mean, it just, and yet here we are. With, you know, self-quarantine, self-isolation of so many in the United States, our economy is shut down. The stocks are like, you know, right now is a buyer's market. And I'm going to say, if you have any extra money laying around and you want to make some money, buy stocks. Call your broker, call somebody who knows what they're talking about, and throw some money down. Okay, I'm telling you that right now. This is a buyer's market. But all because, A, we have a too intertwined economy with people that aren't our friends. I mean, you think if this thing was going on like in Israel, Britain, South Korea, they would warn us. Chinese wanted to do everything they could to keep us from knowing the truth. And they still are. In fact, the doctor that actually warned us, tried to warn the world, was basically, I think they murdered him. Okay. You know, but anyway, we've got this thing that came from someplace that, you know. So I'm going to tell you guys this. I really think you're going to see a global restructuring of trade. Samsung announced today, this morning, like it was 4 a.m. and I woke up and I looked at my iPhone and saw this on Twitter, that they were taking the building of their cell phones out of China. All right, it's the first one I've heard of. But trust me, it's going to go further, okay? And the reason simply is this. You can't trust them. The entire world economy tanked because they wouldn't be honest back in December about what was going on, okay? When the CDC said, hey, we can help you, they were like, F off. And as we go back to the beginning of my statement, that's why I think it was a bioweapon that got out. Okay. And I want to add this. This is on something completely different. Disney stocks are down below $100. I haven't looked at them today, but they have been. And it's a perfect time for some big company to jump in and grab them. And an analyst, I can't remember where the story was, basically said he thought Apple might jump in. Apple's never said a word. And I'm going to say this. I would expect when all this is said and done, there will be a new captain of that ship. And I don't think it's going to come from the outside. I think it's going to come from the inside. And because they have a $59 billion debt, they're in the hole for $750 billion in cash assets, liquid assets. That, I'm going to be perfectly honest with you guys, I think that in the end, somebody else is going to end up running Disney and start selling things off, okay? It's the only way they're going to be able to get money back. It's the only way they can survive, all right? Service industry's cut, you know, they've closed, okay? All the parks are closed, Disney parks, Disney hotels. No one can go to movies, all right? Disney Plus is probably making them a little bit of income, but not much, okay? And all this is due to China, all right? Thanks, guys. Anybody want bat soup? Anybody, you know, want demon spawn from hell delight? This is Steph sending out.